The views and opinions expressed in the video do not necessarily state or reflect our personalities and behavior. Furthermore, our opinions are based from what our eyes can see and will be delivered the way we want it. This video is created just for fun.
Good evening, everyone, or whatever is applicable, good day to everyone. And
oh my God.
Yes, we're here live in Samelo's residence, and we will be having a special post-pageant review of Miss, or of the 65th Miss Universe.
Yes, and oh my God, I don't know what to say. I'm stuck. No, well, we're doing this post-pageant review almost a week after Miss Universe. You know, just to give time for other people to have their own thoughts. And sometimes we got to miss a lot of things because of our outburst of emotion and feeling, because the pageant is just, you know, was just finished during those times. So the two of us decided to have it after like a week. So there, that's why we're here.
So
by the way, my name is Levy, and I've been passionate to, you know, beauty pageants for almost, 20 years. I started 1993, actually 1992, when Rufa Gutierrez. Well, Rufa, you're my idol when it comes to beauty pageants. So, yeah, she is... she influenced me a lot. Annabelle Rama, my God, I will never forget those times when she competed the first time in the Binibining in Pilipinas, 1992.
So, my name is Jeff, and this would be the very first time that I'm doing this kind of review. I'm also an enthusiast. I started when Venus won the fourth runner-up Miss Universe title in the United States, but I can't remember the year.
It's 2010.
Oh, 2010.
That was the year when we finally end the drought.
Yes.
Drought time. And really placing in the Miss Universe beauty contest. Well, I think the last time we placed was 1999,
That's
if
Miriam.
I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Miriam Kembao. So we've been sending really, you know, we thought that we've been sending very strong candidates, but
we never go absent in this universe. Every year we have a representative. Yeah.
I think we started 1951 or 52.
So we've been active in Miss Universe. So.
Oh, no. Because the first Miss Universe was 1951. 54, I think, Nini Ramos.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
That is so history.
Yes. Because we really did not join. We're not the original member of the Miss when it all started, you know. I think on the second year or third year that we joined, but... good thing that when the first time we joined, we actually went into the semifinals. That's just my research.
So let's start.
So since, of course, we're gonna talk about first our fearless forecast. So we did our fearless forecast. Well, I was able to watch the preliminaries, and I had I have all those top. Not top 13, but I actually have 17 of them, because I have alternates, because it's very hard to really decide, because you got to not really listen to them during their interviews, and I think it's really the interview has big weight in terms of the judges, finalizing the top 13, or who will be in the top in the finals, because I think Miss Universe, they're focused more on the substance, that's Miss World. No. I mean the substance of the girl, what they've been through. It's like rags to riches, you know, from someone who's not really famous, then you rise up from like the typical Sharon Cuneta show movie.
From rugs to riches.
Yes, something like that. That I'm going to revenge, something like that. So,
like the Cinderella story.
Yes, so I think they're more of looking now the substance, because there should be a story behind it. Not just because of the beautiful face, beautiful body, but...
Not just a Barbie doll.
Yeah, well, that we actually have a living proof, like Pia Wurstbach, and the rest of the winners that started from what? I think 2014, when Paulina Vega won, and she's, well, she's really a favorite, but then,
The top 13, I think I was able to get half of it, but I only base it on their hour and the hearsays, so. Yeah.
Well, me, I actually base it from preliminaries and then national costume, and of course, popularity, that's gonna be,
Who shocked you in terms of
let's tell them first who are our forecasts.
Okay.
Who are our countries. So me, I will start. I have, of course, Venezuela. Well, Venezuela, because she's just so strong.
But she didn't enter. She was not part of the
top. Sierra Leone. Sierra Leone was, I put her in my list because in terms of substance, no, not beauty. I mean, in terms of something to talk about, she has a lot of story to tell. So that's why, and it's their first time to join.
And Sierra Leone, I also included her in my list because of your influence.
Yes. Then I put South Africa or Australia, which two of them did not.
Australia is also in my list.
Well,
she's very pretty.
Peru is on my list. Brazil, Thailand, Indonesia, Canada, Mexico, Curacao, Colombia, Myanmar, and then Philippines. So I got actually 9.
I got 8.
So there. So now the actual results. So Kenya, what can you say about Kenya?
Kenya was so surprising. I don't know. I'm not really that fan of not to discriminate, but I'm really fan of white.
Black.
No, I'm not really fan of black beauty.
Candidate.
Yes. But, I mean, again, it's
wow, you're so white.
I'm not discriminating. I just really love white beauties.
Yes, because of his color too. No. Well, of course, as someone who is doing a review or doing, you know, I've been in this kind of thing since for a long, long time. So, I know it actually evolved. Unlike before, you can feel really the discrimination with Miss World during Rufa's time up until the end of the 2000s. It's really Europeans
the Caucasians
that would really get a lot of attention. But Miss Universe, somehow they have balance. So just like last year, Miss South Africa was a big surprise.
And Angola.
Well, Angola, Leila Lopez. It's their first time to join, just like Sierra Leone now. That's why I'm rooting for her. So, and Botswana during
the story of Sierra Leone, actually.
Yeah, and it's also happened like 1999 when Miss Botswana won, and Miriam Kimball is the first. It's also
and
their first
Rufa
time.
Rufa Gutierrez was actually defeated by an African,
South African. It was Empule Quigan. I know not Empule. It's Lisa Hanna, Miss Jamaica,
and
who won
Miss Miriam Kemba.
Yeah, it's Empule Guagan Lobby. That's Miss Botswana. Anyway, so that's my first. Kenya is not surprised. It's not. She's not really. Although she's not on my list, but I'm not surprised.
I think many people were surprised when Kenya was actually called as one.
But she's pretty.
She was.
Okay, second was Indonesia, so no question. Simply because she's very tall.
And on the video, the what you call that, the start video?
Video profile?
Is she the last one, or is it Thailand?
No, it was Thailand who did the curtain thing, yeah. Next, of course, USA. Well, I did not really put USA on my list, but she's just an alternate. Simply because she's not that very strong during the preliminaries, unlike the previous Miss USA. I don't know why.
I actually, I love her wit. I think she's one of the wittiest candidates.
Yes, she is. But again, preliminaries
picture. It's more of like
maybe because she really did great. I mean, she really aced the interview round during the preliminaries. That's why she's there.
And she was a soldier.
Yes, she is. She's an officer.
Wow.
She's an active officer in the military. Okay. Next was Miss Mexico. So no question about Mexico. She's really pretty. I saw her video when she was about to come here in the Philippines.
The last Mexican Miss Universe was Ximena.
Ximena.
That starts with X.
Ximena.
And that's the one who defeated Venus.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's really elegant. Anyway, Peru. See, I told you, Peru was on my list. Although Peru has been sending very beautiful candidate, very strong candidate. Maybe this time, it was just because remarkable. I mean, she's remarkable this year. Last year, Peru was one of the tallest. That's why.
Tallest delegate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and now, although I think Peru was on the top six. No, the other year, year prior. But now I actually put her on my list. Then Panama. So I was not surprised with Panama and Peru. And next, of course, Colombia.
Colombia, Andrea Tovar. I think she was, I like her better. I like her compared to the last year candidate, because she's very respectful and her beauty is really awesome.
Yeah, she has a different, darker color. Well, I saw her during the national pageant when Ariadna crowned her, and she's actually, I have second thoughts, because it's really big. There's a big difference between before and now. I saw her during the long gun competition. Well, what I noticed is that she's really bubbly, but during the long-gun competition, it's like she's stiff, maybe because of the dress. It's really
One of the tough candidates. Opponent of our country, I think.
Yes. There. Next, of course, Philippines. I think Miss MUO did it in did it in purpose that Colombia, they would call them next to each other. Because, of course, of the controversy happened last year.
And I love it how Steve presented it.
Yes. Then Canada. Well, Canada is on my list. Well, a lot of people, as I checked all the reviews, they were all shocked when Canada was there. Mm-hmm. Well, for me, I'm not. Because she was on my list, because she's so she's really so fierce during the preliminary. Although she has bigger
I think
body.
The story behind her success is
and
awesome.
Well, maybe the typical beauty queen that will make any comments or any review about the preliminary. They would really look for those girl who has the same body type as them. Because that's what a typical or what ideal beauty queen should be. Now, when I saw Canada, not because I'm big, voluptuous.
From the root word?
Voluptuous. Vola, yeah. Now, well, Canada, she's really good. I mean, again, Miss Universe or being a beauty queen is not because you are. You're not really very sexy and skinny. But of course, not really.
But most of the winners are really
What I mean is not really too fat. Because being confidently beautiful is not because, it's not because of your body type. But of course, you have to take care of yourself.
And it's how you carry yourself.
Yeah, it's not that. If you want to be a beauty queen, you have to know for a fact that you have to be sexy. But when you define the word sexy, it's gonna be big. How do you find
it? Depends on how you execute it.
Yes, but again, for someone who is in this kind of industry, you have to make sure that you take care of yourself. I know you're gonna be sexy in your brain, but your body is really like too big. So that's not sexy. It's just your own belief.
As per the song of Whitney Houston, learning to love yourself.
Yes.
It's the greatest love of all.
Daming kuda. Next, Brazil.
Brazil was actually the forecasted winner of the Missology. I was actually surprised.
Yeah, well, Brazil is not on my list. I just don't find her very, very strong.
But I think she's one of the contender favorites.
Contender. And, well, simply because you know why? Brazil has been sending white for the past how many years now, and it's their first time, you know, that they really send different, you know, biracial something like that, just like Miss Japan. See, Miss Japan did not actually on the top three, top 13 today.
Japan, no.
No, but last year Japan was there because Japan has a story to tell, right?
Okay.
See.
But one of the judges was, the preliminary judges was Ryo Mori.
Mm-hmm. Miss Japan, Miss Universe. Okay, next we have France.
All right.
France, well, I did not include her. She's not remarkable during the preliminaries.
She was also not on my list.
So it's not a big surprise for us, France making it to the final cut. Because, again, it's Europe. Come on, ideally, but Barbie right now, doll, they are very beautiful.
I'm a big fan of France.
Yeah,
after the pageant.
Not just after the pageant, while the pageant.
During the pageant. We became a fan.
Haiti, I think, for me, it's not a big surprise, although she's not on my list, but I guess it's their time today, this year, because I've been rooting Haiti before. I started noticing them 2010 when Venus Ra competed in LA, oh, Nevada, during those time. And I think Haiti is one of those girls who were asked to be in the pageant a week because they would have a press con. I mean, it's like a promotion, they will promote Miss Universe, and Venus Ra was one of them, and Miss Haiti was also one of them. So that's when I started, observing them, that, Haiti will soon be.
And I'm just not sure. Haiti has a resemblance of Ariadna. She looks...
No, Lola Tolentino!
I don't know,
She has,
like Maxine. Maxine has a...
But it's not noticeable, unlike... It's really,
and I've heard Haiti has like
she has a Filipino blood.
Filipino blood, like her grandmother.
Lahat naman meron, putang ina. Nananal, nagay Filipino blood.
That's why after the
remember Miss Trinidad and Tobago bagging the fourth runner up, na meron daw dugong Filipino.
And even Kenya before. Is it Kenya? Nigeria when the time of MJ Lastimosa.
No, that's yun nga, Trinidad and Tobago. Ah, Jamaica pala yun. Jamaica.
Oh.
Diba? Lahat na lang may dugong Pinoy pagka
naging sensation. Who answered about Bob Marley.
Yeah. And of course, the last one, Thailand. Actually, Thailand is on my list. Although, I find it copycat for Thailand. Yeah. Copycat of Pia, but we have to give her the credit, and to the fans of Thailand, she's really good,
she won the fast track because of the Filipino fans, I think.
She's the
social media choice.
Social media. All right, so of course, so after that, here we go.
Back to Thailand. I just when she lost, she cried. Went to her mother. So
well, everybody will cry if you lost, especially that you have high expectation about yourself. Mm-hmm. That's why when you join to any competition, don't think you have to own it. You have to claim that you're the winner, but you don't have to. You have to feel. What I mean is that when you lose, it means to say it's not the end of the world. You know.
Yeah, you just hope for the best, but expect for the worst.
Correct. But of course, you have to make sure that
you will actually
do everything, not just 100%, but do 1,000%.
You have to really prepare, because not preparing, you're preparing yourself to lose.
Correct. Next. So, top 9. So, we did our fearless forecast based from what we see in the swimsuit competition. Although, you know, well, all of the comments about the production, it's very too, it's just too fast. You know, give the girls more moment about how to present themselves on the stage, because again, it's not really just overnight you'll become a beauty queen. Overnight,
I think everything was actually fast. They have to do really fast. Like the introduction of the candidates.
Yeah,
it was
more of like a real reality TV thing. So, well, my suggestion is that give more time for girls to really show off their showcase what they can do on the stage.
But it's more exciting. I think they will tweak it next year.
I definitely. Mm-hmm. They make it slow down, like maybe 30 minutes per candidate. Anyway, so the fearless forecast that I did was Philippines, Canada, Brazil, Thailand, Haiti, France, Mexico, USA, Colombia. On the top nine.
I was only able to get three candidates.
So out of the nine, I got eight.
I got three.
So I think the one that I missed was
Kenya.
Kenya, yeah. Kenya is a really big surprise.
Peru, I did.
No, Peru was not there.
Oh, sorry.
It was because I have Brazil, but Brazil was left out in the top nine, and I don't know why. She did great during the preliminary. I mean, the swimsuit. Well, there's really some.
Actually, France was actually not on my top.
Well, she's on my top nine. Now, moving forward, so then long gone competition. So let's have, you know, one by one, the long gone USA.
There was actually a problem with the cable, so we were not able to.
That's why. But
really,
but
witness how she
here's
walked.
The thing. I forgot the logic behind it, because what I noticed during the previous editions of Miss Universe, it's like the top five, because it's the first time. I mean, last year they started changing the format, but. Seen ever since that they have the top five. So for you to be in the top five, you should
wear the same shirt.
I mean, the color should be outstanding. Mm-hmm. So during Ariela Arida's time, 2013, I know she'll be in the top five because she's the only one who wears yellow. Other wears white. Mm-hmm. So only one white will go in the finals, you know, just like with MJ Lastimosa, I really never thought that she will never make it to the top five. But then Janine Tugonon, the color was Russia during those time, and Janine wears the same color, almost the same blue, but of
the
course,
red prevails.
The blue gown of Janine prevails because she was in the top five and Russia was not. So there. So top six, I have Philippines, Haiti, Kenya, USA, Mexico, and France.
Top six.
That's top six. My fearless forecast. But the actual is Colombia, France, Kenya, Colombia, Philippines, Thailand, Haiti. Well, Colombia, I did not choose her because, again, during the long gone competition, she did not change clothes.
Yeah, I think we eliminated the two of toughest candidates, Thailand and Colombia.
Yes, but I just felt like Thailand during the long gown, it was just so Pia that I saw in her. So that's why I did not put her on my list, because she has to have her own, you know, style,
identity,
not just copycatting or any. But she's really great. She did. We have to accept, guys, that when we judge long gown, it's not really the girl, and it's not really the gown that the girl is wearing. It's the girl who wears the gown, right? So it's a personality. But just during those times, it was Pia that I saw in her, not the gown. So I have to remember. Anyway, so let's go now to the top, the question.
The
nerve-wracking. Question. So I actually did a lot
something
of...
Something to do with the experience that... where you fail and then what you've learned from it.
Well, actually the questions before last year was better than today. I think this year they really did not research and really thought about it, because look at how the question was given to Miss Kenya. I think she was set up for failure, because Kenya was very...
All of the questions are actually
but I mean, it's not really relevant to anyone, right? Mm-hmm. But again, it was Steve Harvey said that
winning has something to do really with
the question will be, you know, depends on the background or whatever, just like what last year, right? Mm-hmm. So it's more of the current issues that the country is facing.
The world is facing.
Not just, I mean, the current situation or current issues in where you're from, right? So that's why Pia was asked about the military base, then... Francis was asked about terrorism, right? Remember?
USA was about the USA gun
about the gun ownership. So there's a relevance, but this time there's none.
It's really like, so it's like out of the blue, anything under the sun.
So if
and the, that I think more, that add more spices or more excitement.
That's in good, terms of but again, stuff. I think during the show they mentioned it that the question will be based from the recent issue that your country is facing.
Like that, right? They were not able to set proper expectations.
Why would you ask Kenya about Donald Trump?
Because I think U.S. is one of the most powerful countries.
Yeah,
in the world,
but again, so you don't have to really. For someone who
doesn't live
in the U.S.,
country.
Why would you mind other countries' problem? You should mind your own problem first, or your country's.
Poor Kenya, but I love her gown.
Yeah, so it was like she was set up for failure. That's why, actually, when we did our fearless forecast, I have number one as to be
like
in the top six,
top
right?
Six.
In the top six, we have
top three.
The top three, I have Colombia, France, and Haiti.
No, the four, they're competing with each other.
Yeah, the first one was Colombia, France, then Haiti. That actually, I only have top two.
Mm-hmm.
Because the rest of them are three. Haiti,
Philippines,
Kenya. And Thailand.
Kenya and Thailand.
No, yeah, and Kenya. So four of them, actually.
The answer was too shallow. Oh, I mean,
there's no relevance at all. It's like, there's no sense. Mm-hmm. So like I really don't. I really can't.
Taken out of the context.
It's out of the context. So I really don't. I really can't decide who will be in the top three. So I just said, whoever will be in that third.
Like
spot,
there should be a raffle.
Okay. Yeah. Let them, you know, let other just kill each other, and the best woman, the best girl wins. So I have Colombia, France as my first two choice. Then the third, I just scratch it out. Whoever will be in the third finalist, it's fine. So it was Haiti that was chosen.
But so, for me, Colombia is better compared to Haiti. I'm just not.
No. We're not yet on the top three. We're just based on the six questions.
Mm-hmm.
So now we have the top three. So Colombia, France, and Haiti. So they were asked. What was that question?
Name something in your life that you failed at and what you've learned from that experience.
Yes. So, very, very
question to the
stereotype question. Mm-hmm. That question is always asked, and most probably when they had their question and answer training, it's been asked, and it's been taught to them how to really answer or ace that kind of question. But of course, you just have to. Again, with all the pressure, with all those people looking at you, a million of viewers, even though you may be you're memorized
prepared,
it's just your heart beats faster than your brain. So Colombia was asked first.
Colombia's answer was too broad, and it doesn't.
It's not really specific. So I said that, what went wrong?
But her answer has sense.
It has. It's
but
really sensible.
It's not straight to the point.
It's sensible, but it's not relevant.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
And it's not specific. That's why. All right. Now Haiti.
Speaking of Haiti, being very specific.
She is very specific.
About the earthquake.
Yeah, that's right. It's actually Haiti and France. But look at her
execution.
The way she executed it. When the question was asked, she said, please.
Can you repeat the question? To Steve Harvey. No please at all.
Can you repeat the question?
Mm-hmm.
So for me, for someone who did not get it the first time, so that's already a no, it's a ding.
Mm-hmm.
It's a ding already for me.
But
if in case you really missed out the question, maybe because of the micro, of the audio settings or whatever, because of maybe a lot of butterflies, you know, flying in your stomach, that is what you
hear. Or maybe that's her strategy, so when she, when the question will be repeated, she can think of an answer.
Yeah, I know how you would have your own style. But then the problem was, the way it was executed and delivered, it should have been like, oh, sorry, can you please repeat the question? It has to be courteous. So that same, you know, the time that she said that, I already take her out from my list to be the Miss Universe. So that's when, I actually have Colombia out because of the way she answered it. Haiti out because of her attitude. Then Miss France was able to answer the question. So that's when I feel like, oh yeah, she is the winner.
And there was this issues that the interpreter was not really, they did not interpret it right.
Correct.
The answer of Miss France is more...
deeper than that. It's actually not casting call. It's about her studies in the medical school. But because I think the first try, she failed. Her name was not included on the final list of those student who passed the medical examination, I think, entrance examination. Then she really studied very hard. And the last...
She incorporated it in the Miss Universe, I think.
Yeah, and what I love about it, she said that what I have learned in life is that when you fail, you just don't stop, you know, dreaming about it. Just like what Pia did. That's when I said, okay, Miss France, give the crown to her. So
I got the right
forecast. So I have Colombia as second runner up, then Haiti first runner up, and France is the Miss Universe.
So
about you, who's your...
Actually, I don't have any forecast because I only listen to you. I think you were like the... But she is calibrated with the choices of the judges, and I actually gave kudos to her.
Yes, because again,
to him pala, sorry.
To it?
Okay. Kahit ano.
So there. So we were gonna be doing this. Well, we missed Miss World because I think you are.
I'm in Baguio.
You're in the mountain province.
Somewhere in north, yeah.
Yeah, you're in Banaue. So I was only the one who's watching, but I've been, you know, my Facebook is really very, very noisy if there's like a Miss World, Miss Universe. But Miss International, not really, because...
Supranational, yeah. It's just like...
Supranational, well,
we'll do this for Binibining Pilipinas.
Yes, we're gonna do this for Binibining Pilipinas, well... Binibining Pilipinas is on, so well, that's true. I remember we just saw Jonas Kafud's interview about Maxine's, you know, competing in the Philippines. It's really hard when you are competing in your hometown and
so
your own
bashing.
Country. Yes, it's really hard. It's really hard to please your own people, right?
Correct.
Even our,
and it's only a show. It's the show, the pageant is subjective. It really depends with the math, with the taste of the judges.
Yes.
So
if you want to,
they are winners in their own way.
Correct. And being in the Miss Universe or being in any competition that takes a lot of hard work, you don't just let that person down because of what you want to see on them, but you have to understand
what they're going through.
And what they've been through. While in the process of getting where they are, right? So it's not an easy task.
Correct.
To be a beauty queen.
So
right. So it's not also answer there.
30 minutes there and there.
Yeah, wait up. We're not yet done. So to end up, so it was caught. So there. So wait for our Binibining Pilipinas. But we cannot do fearless forecast with Binibining Pilipinas. It's sometimes very hard. Maybe we'll just have a post review after. Anyway, so thank you so much for listening, and I hope that we're gonna upload this in YouTube, definitely. So again, my name is Ate Jasmine Abolencia.
I'm Daisy Abolencia.
And we are the Abolencia Sisters, kung alam nyo. If you know Abolencia Sisters, like, what's that?
Kadena Bulaklak.
DVR. And we, oh, I hope you can watch our
YouTube songs we sang
in YouTube. We have some, you know,
videos
there
that will make you
watch.
Laugh, yes. And will entertain you.
Nakakita ka ng boses, mukhang lalaki pero kumanta boses. Oh my God.
Boses, I know. No profanity on videos.
Yes, boses. Okay, so thank you so much, guys, for listening. Ciao.